I am John Skeeters, and I appreciate you taking time out to learn more about our project. My mom and dad started a restaurant business in Atlantic Beach in 1952. They had a good, very good restaurant business and fed a lot of mouths in that very restaurant that you were looking at back there. That's when they went on the business adventure in 1952. An interesting story, some of the people that they fed in that restaurant were a lot of the entertainers that came to the Myrtle Beach area and played and entertained at the Ocean Forts and some of the larger hotels around the beach area. They could play music there, but they couldn't live in a hotel, so they ended up living in Atlantic Beach during that era of time there. But we had good business here that brought extra business in to the town of Atlantic Beach. And this is where all the action was.
Yes, it was, John Skeeter. This is where all the action was.
Water dog, good to see you.
Hello, my brother.
Well,
how are you? Boy, I'm telling you, did we have some great times down here.
We had some great times.
It was wonderful. You know, this year was 50 years that your family actually raised me. Your mom and dad and your deceased brother, Raymond, was my best friend. But if people only knew, like at Punk's Patio and the other patios and even at your parents' patio, all the superstars that stayed here on Atlantic Beach, as segregation was very prevalent. Jackie Wilson, the Four Tops, the Temptations, Billy Stewart. I mean, they were here, weren't they, John? Anthony?
They were here. All the stars were here, and they had to go play at the Ocean Forest and places like that. But all of them had to live in Atlantic Beach here.
And we didn't mind a bit.
We didn't mind a bit. That brought popularity to Atlantic Beach, especially places like Punk Patio and my mom and dad place, because they fed a many meals to the celebrities.
Well, not only a many. Where could you get a better pork chop sandwich than from Mama Skeeter?
All right.
Lord have mercy.
Johnny Dollar.
Atlantic Beach was established in 1934 as an oceanfront community for blacks who couldn't go to the surrounding beaches because of segregation. Many moved here and started families. Others kept coming back to vacation every year. Atlantic Beach, the Black Pearl, was one of the most popular resorts on the East Coast from Virginia to Florida. That was then, but things are different now. In 1975, because of desegregation, black families could go to any beach they wanted to, and go they did, leaving Atlantic Beach behind.
Oh, how?
Today, there are growing numbers of people passionate about helping Atlantic Beach grow popular as she once was.
Atlantic Beach has a rich history. Of course, I didn't come down here until 1966. And I was mayor from 1975 until 1974. And we tried to revitalize the town. The community center was built under my administration. All the streets were paved. Fire hydrants were installed. And several other things were done. And the town was very prosperous during those years. We had people coming. You could see people on the beach every day. Today is a different story. And we would like to see those people return. And we would like the town to be revitalized. And I think what you and John Skeet and others are doing is a step in that direction. And our residential areas are very good. We have middle-income family, and we have family that are not poor. I'm not poor, but it went out stating that everybody in this town was poor, and that's a bad image. And I'm going to approach the administration to try to, counteract news like that, because everybody living here not poor. We need to revitalize the business area, but the residential areas, we have a home close to $1 million here, a great. So that story needs to be told. It's not told. That when people come here, they only see the dilapidated been on two streets. That's 30th Avenue and 31st Avenue. They don't go on 29th or where we just left, where John Skeeter lived, or where I live across the highway. They don't see that. So all of it needs to be seen.
You know, it's a pleasure to be back here in Atlantic Beach. I remember 50, 45 years ago how beautiful the town was, and you could come here any Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and you couldn't find a place to stay or park. The families came from miles and miles around. We had beautiful mom and pop motels here. We had outstanding food. We had all type of entertainment to offer people. The beaches were as beautiful as they are anywhere whatsoever. And it went through some transition time that really was hurtful to a number of us, like Brother John Skeeter, who's heading up this community project. Hopefully that we'll be able to succeed in raising funds to beautify and to do many other things in the town. I think Chief Eric Lewis and his officer Randy Fisher have done a wonderful job in doing a lot of cleaning up here. But John has a vision, as my wife Mikey and I have, and that's to do concerts right here on Atlantic Beach and bring thousands of people in here. And Rome wasn't built overnight, and it's going to take us time to build that to happen. But I can guarantee you, I'm going to do everything in my power to make it happen. And I hope that the citizens of Atlantic Beach will back John Skeeter and his group of people who see what they need to do. They see the forest. They don't just look at one tree. Back Eric Lewis, Chief Lewis, what a great job he's doing for the city. Back his officers. And good God, I can't wait to the day to see the high rises right here on Oceanfront. And to me, a place that is so dear to my heart.
One thing about it was a lot of visitors here. We had a lot of visitors here on the beach. You couldn't hardly walk the street. It was a dirt road. It wasn't paved. And you couldn't hardly, you know, you couldn't hardly walk because there were so many people. It was so crowded and stuff. But I enjoy being here because I raised all four of my kids here. Yeah, a lot of changes around us. Not as much change as I like to see here on Atlantic Beach. There's a lot of buildings that's been torn down, and the storm has moved some of them. But other than that, I would like to see not the front part of the beach built up, but I like to see the second street built. A lot of the young ones that was here that couldn't build it up, they've moved away. They're not here anymore because the jobs are not here for them. So they've moved different states. And I would like to see some of them come back to be able to help build up Atlantic Beach. And I've seen a lot of changes. I've been here when they had the patios on both sides. But, you know, the storm came, and then the fire burnt one, and the storm kind of took one of them down. But and we don't have too many more older buildings that was here when I came. It's only one left now, and that's the one down there with the porch on it. That's been a long old building that was here. And I used to work at the daycare, because they had daycare down halfway down the block. I used to work there with the kids. And I don't know, I just enjoy being at Atlantic Beach, that's it. Because I could have gone like everybody else, but I just choose to stay here because I like it here. Beautiful spot. Yeah.
I remember the times when they had the dance hall down towards that end, and you know, there was a dance hall. There was also several halls along here where you could actually go and entertain, where you could play arcades, and I remember when they used to serve hot dogs and hamburgers and stuff like that from this very corner. I can remember when they used to set up the little fairground right there where you could actually ride little carousels and do different things like that. This place was a lively place. It was a place full of memories. I used to come down here when I was, 8 years old, and now I'm 45, so that shows you time has passed. But, I hated that a lot of the memories are fading, because this place holds a lot of memories for a lot of people. And I just wish that, people would start, investing back into it again, because it really is a place where, that we could always call our own. I mean, even though times have been diverse and people are starting to forget about the old stigma of this being separated and that being separated, it comes a time when we need to all come back together and say, what memories does it hold for you? And the memories that it held for me, as well as a lot of people that I talked to, even from Greensboro, even from North Carolina, even from Virginia, it holds a lot of memories. And this place is full of laughter that I still hear. It's full of love that I still feel. I mean, it's something we need to all learn to enjoy and definitely invest back into. The Black Pearl, that's what they call it. Let's see if we can make it happen again. Black Pearl can still shine.
We have great ideas, and working them to make them a reality, that's the goal that we are trying to seek. During our weekend festival here in Atlantic Beach, we will open up our streets, and we will open up our clubs, and we will just have a good time, come together to enjoy ourselves in this festival weekend. Of course, there will be added attractions like arts and crafts and food here with the vendors. So come on and join us for our festival. It's not just about the history. You see, we aren't going to be around forever, and we want to see new ideas and a youthful direction taken for our community. Our legacy will be that we have established a firm foundation for everyone to come and rediscover the Black Pearl.
Imagine festivals all year round. Picture yourself relaxing on a breezy summer night as a local band plays on a nearby stage, or strolling through arts and crafts lined street as children play in a nearby park, or enjoying a fresh meal prepared by local chefs. To get started and help Atlantic Beach with some important beautification plans, our group is planning some auctions organized by Southern Sisters to go along with the festivals. Proceeds from the auctions will be directed to beautification projects that will spruce up Atlantic Beach, like handicapped beach accesses, a welcome to Atlantic Beach sign on the highway, and adding plants, trees, and flowers that will add to the visual beauty of our community, Atlantic Beach.
Do you have something Southern Sisters can auction to help raise money for the town of Atlantic Beach? We need you.
Can you volunteer your time to help us? We need you.
Can you donate services from your company or corporation? We need you to help us.
Can you? I thought so.
The Atlantic Beach restoration effort will have a lasting effect on future generations.
And help people learn about the Black Pearl, a community that was born out of necessity.
A beach town that created many, many memories for so many people, including myself.
We want you to be involved. Come see us. We'll show you how you can help. I'm excited about the future of Atlantic Beach because of where we came from.